Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at playing the keyboards in GarageBand for iPad. So when you go to the instruments in GarageBand, you can see that there's two keyboards. There's regular keyboards and smart keyboards. Let's start with regular keyboards. When you go there, you get a keyboard at the bottom and lots of controls at the top. And basically to play, you tap a key. And then you can tap more than one key at the same time. And you can even tap and then move your finger to play multiple keys. Now you're not stuck with just this view of the keyboard. If you press the button at the very right, you can see that you can stack the keyboards one on top of the other like that. And then you can see there you have different octaves that are shown at the top and at the bottom. You can go back to the single layer. And you can also have change the width of the keys to one of three varieties. And you have a velocity control there as well. Now if you want to change which octave is shown, then the control's on the left there. You can see it says zero. I can tap on the button there and I can change the octave. So here I get middle C is that. I can go up two octaves. You also have a sustain control, so I can turn that on. You can see the sustain, it will just keep going, and then if I turn it off, you can see it doesn't sustain. You can see I also have this scale button here. If I press that, I can then look and change from a regular keyboard to a scale, like say a major blues scale. And now instead of a keyboard there, it looks like a piano, I have just the keys that fit that scale. It makes it very easy to play interesting music. And another interesting setting here is this one, I think it's pronounced arpeggiator, and you can turn that on and then you can simply hold a key down and it will basically play something like this. And of course you can adjust those controls there to change the exact sequence of notes that are played. Now if you really know what you're doing, you may want to actually go and play keys that are beyond the edge of the keyboard. And the only way to get there is by switching the octaves there with those arrow keys, or you can change the middle control here to scroll. Now instead of when I move my finger left to right, instead of rolling over to the next note, it actually scrolls the entire keyboard. I can scroll left to right. So I want to hit the individual notes and then hit and hold and scroll to actually bring the keyboard left to right, so I can play a wider range of notes that way if I'm quick with my fingers. Okay, now let's look at the instruments. Now if I tap on the grand piano at the top there, I can see there are a ton of instruments here because I've got these tabs at the top. So right now I'm looking at keyboards and I can go and choose another keyboard, like go to classic grand or electric piano, all sorts of different ones. And you can see some of these even have controls. So I can change, say, the decay, and I can work with other things as well. And then even some of these, like here, there's that pitch control in the upper left that I could use. Obviously, this is for simulating electronic instruments. You can see the different controls here for the classic rock organ. There's tons of different things here. Now I can dig deeper in instruments by using the tabs at the top. So for instance, if I go to classics here, I go to classic keyboards and I can choose one of these, but also you can see there are two dots at the bottom, meaning I can scroll left to right and see that there's even more keyboards under here. I can go to bass, there's tons of them. Lead synthesizers, there's all sorts of cool synthesizers in here, and you can see I've got more controls. And I can control them while the note's actually playing. I go to pads, there's two sets of pads, and then I can even go to special effects. Turn that off so you can hear. I can even save instruments. So for instance, if I go to a synthesizer here and change some of the controls in the upper right and a few different things about it, have it play a certain scale, do a whole bunch of different things that are modifications of this keyboard. And then I go to the keyboards here, I can hit the save button at the top right and give it a name. And now I get another set there called custom And I can just go to that and find my custom keyboard settings. Now in parts 1 and 2 of this I showed you how to, of course, play an instrument and record it. You do the same thing here. You hit the record button at the top right and then you play. And you hit stop. And now if I go to my song, the loops, you can see in addition to the ones I had previously recorded, I've got a grand piano there. And I can select that, and I can even go in and edit it if I wanted to get very technical with each of the different things here. It even gives me a little keyboard on the side when I'm editing, where I can play the notes. And I can move these left and right and drag them out. Now also, very quickly, let's go and take a look at smart keyboards. And this is very similar to how a smart guitar works. You can do a variety of different things. You can pick the keyboard here, and then you can just get a whole chord here at the top. And at the bottom, you kind of get the left hand. You get the bass note. And you can combine them. Then you can also do a sequence here. And you can play the top and the bottom separately. Change the sequence at the top. So that's just a very easy way to add some chords. And some bass notes to your song without having to actually go into the full keyboard interface. So there's a quick look at using the two different types of keyboards in GarageBand for iPad. It's a lot of fun to play with. There's a lot of different things. You really need to play around with it and get used to the interface and just have fun with it in order to learn it. And then you can start to use it to compose music. Hope you found this interesting. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.